So in this chapter we want to have this result for the particles, and this is the old version, and we will render it to have those renders. So let's go. So as we've seen just before, I would like to extend a bit more the destruction over the nose and over this area as well, and I would like as well to break those kind of shapes by getting more variation inside the smoke simulation. So let's do it. Let's go to the growth solver, and I think I just need to make it this at 130. So let's check that, and we'd like to render it. So let's check what we have now. The frame 150, and this is better. So before we add this frame, this kind of diffusion, and now this is that. So this is good for me. Let's go back to our smoke simulation. And so first of all, I think it would be a good idea to blast the eyes because actually I don't need it. So let's do it. Blast. I want the eyes. Okay, and it's not there anymore, so that's good. Let's go back to our collider. Good. Let's make it a bit more eroded, and let's catch this. Okay, so let's check it. Yes, everything seems to be consistent. And let's go back on this part. Let's have a black background. So the density, okay. Maybe I would like to change a bit the, let's say, the particle size from the pyro source. So let's make it to 1. But then I would like to add to increase a bit the density with a fit, for example, or a multiply, but let's say a fit. Yes, I think something like this should be nice. Okay, let's dive inside our smoke simulation, and first of all I would like to decrease the resolution, not the resolution, the division size, and then increase the resolution. Maybe set the padding to 0.15 to optimize it, and decrease this one as well, increase the disturbance to get more variation, and maybe have a slower motion or overall during the simulation. So let's set this to 0.75, and I think it's good to me. So let's cache everything. Okay, so now let's check there. Yes, I think it's better. Yes, good, it's good to me. Now we'd like to go back to the particle simulation, but I don't want to iterate over all those particles, so let's take this off and go back to this one, not the first, I want the first frame. Okay, and I would like to add more variation, so I can do it directly with the stick pose and by changing this one. So let's take off the substract there. And I would like to do it not directly with the cut edge, but with the fit. So let's promote those. Okay. And get those parameters. And I would like to subtract the same as we had before, but on those parameters. So let's do it like this. Copy paste. Okay, and now I need the clamp, so I don't need it anymore on this one. Okay, good. So now, a last thing, I think it would be nice to, let's say, mix the velocity by the cut stage as well. So let's say the previous velocity with the zero. Let's say zero. With that, I think we will get more compact and smoother as well transition between the position to the simulation. So let's go that. Let's take that. And if I don't like it, I will take it off. So now we need to check the result of all of those. So let's take off the the cache, go to the particle, to the primitive, sorry, and let's create a flipbook. So this is our flipbook. I like the motion, those kind of shapes, that's very nice. We can see the collision there as well, just there. And this is fine for me. And at the frame 150, we have more destruction on those areas, so this is good. But I was wondering, maybe this is the alpha, maybe at some point I would see the background, even though there will be the particles, but I don't want that. So I would like to add another layer from a geometry layer. So let's do it. From the third layer, this I will take this as base. So point from volume, not you, like this. Okay, let's say 0.1, it's good, jitter scale, okay, VDB from particle fluid, and I will convert it to geometry just after, let's say 0.1, 0.3, okay, VDB convert, to be a kind of flesh, polygon, okay, but I need to make it move now. To deform it, so I will use a point deform, and I need the original, so let's copy that. Good, let's set this. Okay, and I need to do it there as well. Okay, I need a time shift to freeze the first frame, I mean the rest frame, and I will use the global control, copy and pass the parameter. Okay, so this is good. Rest, deform, another one. I need to set this in black and check if it works. Okay, this is good to me. Now we'll have to add the trail to compute the velocity, to get motion blur or something like this, even though it's not extremely necessary, but you never know. And I will make central difference, actually it will be more accurate. Let's call it out flesh. I need to cache it as well, so my grid market cloud cache, good, let's call it flesh. Again, I need the frame range, copy. Where is it? It's there. I need the BGOSC. And I think it's good, almost. Yes. So let's cache this. Okay, this is good. So I want to check it. Okay, this is nice to me. Maybe a blue color. And I would like to make a bit more room for all of those. Okay, I think it's better. So now let's check the motion blur. Let's go back there. I don't want to compute anything. Just think, not you. Render flesh. So our geometry, let's import it as well there. Out flesh. Okay. And this is good, I guess. I would like to change the shading. So let's copy past the eyes because it's going to be the same. And I want to make it there as well. Flesh. Good. In order to check the motion blur, I need to turn off the velocity blur. So, for all of them, sampling, velocity blur. And this is good. Okay. So now let's do it. Out. First of all, I would like to check not the field, the motion blur, but directly to the flesh to see if there is any problem with this geometry. So let's go with the render view and render it. Okay. So let's keep this frame and set the motion blur. Yeah, there are small changes, but just to be sure, I would like to check the cache. Flash. Do I have the velocity? Yes, so it should be good. And let's check the head as well. So I don't want to get everything. I mean, this is quite good. So let's check the 10 first frame, let's say. I would like to reset the simulation. Take it like this, go to the out, get back my head geometry, not you, the head, and let's check it. So this is what I have with the motion blur over the frame 30, and let's check without it. So okay, so this is what we want. Perfect. Now, before caching, I just want to make sure that we have something on the flesh, because it was very subtle and I'm not really sure. So let's go back there. Okay, let's check the velocity. It seems to be there. Okay, this is good. So let's cache everything. And before that, let's get the first frame, the merge there, and I think that's it. So, render. So this is the flipbook that I've made from the cache. So let's check it, and I like it, so it's good to me. Even though we have some artifact there, it's not going to be visible at the render time, so that's okay. And I would like to show you the comparison with the new version and the old version. So let's start them together, almost, yes, like this. And I think it's way better this one. So that's nice. And now I would like to show you a render that I've done. Just there, not you, not you, not you. So I've rendered the frame 110 just to show, and I've tried to get the particular red. So this is the result, and as you can see there, there is a couple of particles we don't want to see. So in order to fix that, I just need to go there and change a bit the p-scale. You could redo the cache and get a deeper peak here, but I don't want to, and I just want to reset the p-scale and let's say 30. And let's try again this one. So it's almost done, but we can already check. So this is the new, and this was the old. So this is exactly what we want. So this is good. Now let's set the render settings. So I want a couple of things. First of all, I want a new pass, extra image planes, and I want, what do I want? I want the combined lighting per light. This is what I want. Yes. We are going to render it just after, but let's finish it. Rendering, let's set the limit, reflect limit 2, refract 2, diffuse 0, that's good. I need to set the output, so let's copy past my path, just like this. This is good. Now let's increase the sampling to 6.6, and maybe as well enable or allow a depth of field and a motion blur. And let's set back as well the shading, the color of the particles. Good. And can we render that? Okay, so this is done. I like it, but I want to check as well the light paths. So this is the area light and the environment light. So I think we are ready to render it. But before the renders, I need to set the grid market workflow. with the cache. So let's do that. Okay, so let's dive inside this one. I need those one, I will upload it. This, so I need to spawn rope and it will be good. Load cache, this is good. Let's go on this one. So this one I need to load. I need, I will take PGYC and spawn rope as well. Only strict. The only strict is very important. This is good as well. There it's, okay. Flesh, I need to load the cache. I need to spawn rope as well. Spawn rope. Spawn rope. Same. Okay, almost good. And we are good, I guess. Did I? Yes. Okay, so everything is there. This one, this one, this one. Collider, this one, smoke sim, the growth solver, the particle simulation. I need to set the dependency now. So the first I need to do is this one. For the collision, I'm using the original, I guess. Yes, same thing. No, not for this one. So let's go back and set the growth solver point behind it. Now the collider behind this one. Same thing for the smoke, but I need the collider as well. Particle simulation after everything, so I need a merge. This one, this one, this one. That's good. And for the flesh, I need, what do I need? Not you. So for the flesh, I need this one, and it's the original one. So like this. And I need to merge everything to render. Up. Like this. And there is another node called submit. Grid market render submit. Like this. I need to set this one as well. Render frame up. I need global control. Set the frame range, copy parameter, out, past volatile reference. I think everything is good. Here I just need to set the intersect strict frame range and I can render it. So let's do it. So this is the render. I like it. I like the depth of field as well, so this is good. Even the propagation there, so that's nice. And this is the compositing. So I will not explain and see the compositing part because I don't think it's very interesting, because there is almost nothing, just a bit of exposition, gamma, a photo filter for the color, a bit of glow there as well, a mask for hiding the neck, a bit of grain, and that's it. So nothing very complicated, and I hope you like it too, so let me know.